Hi, I'm Revanth. This is part 10 of a web services video series. In this session, we will learn authentication in web service. This is continuation to part 10. In this session, we will learn consuming authentication web service in client application. So let's begin the tutorial. If you haven't watched part 10 of this video series, I strongly recommend to watch before proceeding this video. In the previous video, we have discussed authentication in web service, like importing the namespace system.web.services.protocols.soap header namespace. If the soap message has the soap header with authentication credentials, we can need to pass through that. Now let's quickly create the client application and consume this authentication in web service. Let's flip to Visual Studio. This is the web service created in the previous video. This is the authentication user. We have imported the namespace system.web.services.protocols.soap header namespace, created the two properties, and this is valid property will return true if the user found from the database. And if the user does not found in the database, it returns false. Like we have created a simple database with the table TBL authentication user with three columns, like ID has the primary key and username and the password. I have inserted one row with a username and password has the Revanth. This is a web service. When we call this method, if the user credentials are valid, it should return hello with the username what we have passed to the service. Now let's create a client application and consume this web service. Let's flip to Visual Studio. Click on File, New, Website. Select a template has Visual C Sharp and .NET 4.5. Select ASP.NET MT website. Rename the project as Client Authentication Web Service. Click on OK button. That will create the project. Once the project is created, right click on the project. Click on Add Service Reference. We have to specify the URL. Before specifying the URL, let's run the project. Web service, right click on the authentication.asmx file, click on view in browser. Now copy this URL, paste it here. Now click on go button. So hello world method is created. Namespace as service reference 1. Click on OK button. That will create the client proxy in our client application. Now right click on the project. Click on add new item. Select a web form. And let it be default.aspx. Click on add button. And to consume the time, I have already written the code. Let's copy and paste. Code is very straightforward. Here the table I have used to format it properly with style. Font family has Arial with one tr with username. To enter the username, I have used the text box, and for password, I have used the text box and one button with one label. This is a design view. Let's create an event handler for this button. Double click on this login button. That will create the event handler for this button click. Now let's write the service connection to connect to the web service. Has a service reference 1 dot my service soap client int equal to new service reference 1 dot my service soap client. Call the hello world method client dot hello world method. Look at that, it is expecting the authentication user, which is need to pass the username and the password for this authentication user to authenticate a valid user or not. So now let's create service reference 1 dot authentication user, user equal to username equal to text box username dot text dot trim. We have to give the comma here and password equal to txt password dot text dot trim. Trim will remove any white spaces which is used at the end of the string value in the text box. Now let's pass this username here. That's it. This client dot hello world method will return the string value. So let's display that string value as the response in the label. That's it. Save the project. Let's build the solution. Let's run the application in debug mode. First, we can run this web service. Now run this client application. Let's give the username as Revanth and password has XYZ. So this is invalid password. Let's click on login button. So we have given user with username and password. This is a username and the password. It goes to the service, web service, and it will check if the user is valid or not in the database. So it will check user dot is valid. Let's right click on this method, click on go to definition. So this method will return true or false. If the user found in the database, it will return true or else it will return false. So user dot is valid, it is false, so it is returning invalid user details. So look at this, invalid user details found in the database. Now let's give the valid password. Now click on login button. So user dot is valid found from the database. So it returns true. So we get the result as hello Revanth, the user which we have passed here. In the next tutorial, we will discuss token-based authentication in web service.
Thanks for watching. For references and resources, visit these links and subscribe to my YouTube channel for email alerts. Thank you.